Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. Can I have your attention? Oh, you guys are great. I didn't even have to resort to the, you know, when I raise my hand, be quiet or something like that, a teacher's thing. Welcome to the 100th annual meeting of the United Way of Greater Plymouth County, our campaign celebration, our time that we can offer all of the things that we're thankful for at United Way. We are going to begin today's program with a very important presentation regarding our community partners, who are literally the hands and feet and heart and soul of United Way, our community partners.
Young people are talking, they want action, and they want it now. They want to change the direction that we're walking, and the lack of common sense that our laws allow. Some people are saying that the young folks just don't understand, but a raging silent revolution is rising up all across the land, and it's gonna get louder, it's gonna get crazy, it's picking up power, picking up steam. They're gonna get louder, it's about to get real. Young people are thinking with a mind that's all their own. They are ready, willing, and they are able. Why don't we just let them take control? They're gonna fight the fight till they find the answers. They're gonna do what we have failed to do. They're gonna throw all the cards on the table. Their life, they're giving voices to, and they're gonna get louder, they're gonna get crazy, they're picking up power, picking up steam. We got a new generation, and it's stronger than steel. They're gonna get louder, it's about to get real. I'm dreaming of a transformation like the world has never seen. Around the world and across every nation, there's a whisper turning to a scream, and it's gonna get about to get real, and they're gonna get louder, gonna get crazy, picking up power, picking up steam,
picking up steam.
We got a new generation, stronger than steel. They're gonna get louder, it's about to get real. About to get real. It's gonna get louder. It's about to get real.
Would all of those people who are connected, work for, work with our community's partners, please stand up? These are the hands and feet and the heart and soul of the organizations that do the work that United Way is raising resources for. Please give them a thunderous round of applause. Thank you. You folks are the best. Please take your seats. I'd like to thank our Director of Community Relations and Marketing, Kim Scotland, who puts all of our media things together. And if you're thinking of stealing her, don't even think about it. I just want you to know now, this is an age where it's tough enough to hire and retain people. You want to mess with us, United Way can get really tough about these things. Anyway, we thank Kim for the work that she does every day in regards to this. At this point, yes, thank you. It does deserve a round of applause. Absolutely. At this time, I'm going to ask one of our community partners, and Holly Jennings, who is the programs manager of the Imagine Arts program for the South Shore Conservatory. She also is the grants administrator. She's also the voice instructor. So she's a performer and teacher and does all these great things. And Holly is going to come up and sing the national anthem for us. Please stand. This superlative is going to get overused today, but wow. Thank you. Thank you, Holly. That was terrific. And thank you for the South Shore Conservatory for letting us hear you this morning, which is really great. Thank you. It is great to be back in person and to be able to see you all face to face. Whatever you need to do to feel comfortable in terms of masking is totally fine. Please respect each other's kind of thoughts around this and concerns so that we are making sure everybody feels comfortable. Your only task today is to enjoy yourselves. So we want you to certainly take care of that. At this time, it gives me great pleasure and honor to introduce our board member and pastor of the New Life Temple of Holiness, Pastor Michael Gilbert, for today's invocation. Pastor.
Good afternoon. May we bow our heads. We are called to be aware of the chasm of hunger and housing and health care. We are called to an act of justice. We are called to bring forth comfort and healing to our families, our friends, and our neighbors. We are called to advocate for the poor and to promote and defend human dignity at every opportunity. With these things in mind, let us pray together. Our Creator and our God, However we envision you, we give you thanks for all these blessings of life, especially the gift of those in each other of our work. Every person here is a treasure, every life a sacred gift. May the work we do diminish the chasm of disparity and bring about a greater justice, equity, and compassion. We ask humbly for your wisdom, your guidance, your strength, and your mercy. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Gilbert. It is now my great honor to be able to introduce the chairman of our board, John Doyle of UPS, in order to thank our corporate sponsors for today's event.
Thank you, Dennis. So first, I'm going to say good afternoon, everybody. We're past noon, so I can say good afternoon. But how cool is it to be back in person? It's been a couple long years of doing virtual events, but the 100-year anniversary back in person. This is a pretty historic moment, right? We're celebrating 100 years. And we're in the room, we get to celebrate this 100 years, but there's 99 years before us, right, of great people that have carried this United Way forward. And we get to celebrate the 100th year anniversary, which again, I think is pretty cool. So another round of applause. Have your hands ready, because there's going to be a lot of applause with my part. I'm doing the recognition, and Dennis, I'm probably going to go off script a little bit, so it may go a little bit longer than planned, but I think it's appropriate. First, I'm going to recognize, and I want a big shout out from the UPS people here. We're the premier sponsor this year. I want to thank our company for coming forward to do that. It's a great, great company when it comes to community partnership. So big round of applause for UPS and what we do for the community. And we have some people that traveled in pretty far, too, from Texas even, to participate in this day, so that's pretty cool. And then I want to, you know, I'd like to thank UPS for their commitment to the community. You know, I've been with UPS 33 years now. It'll be 34 later this year. And over these 33 years, I've been involved with the United Way for all 33 of them. You know, at first it was, you know, basically the arm twist. Give to the campaign. And at that point, I really didn't even know what United Way was. But the education that we have, the grassroots program that we have, we start at the ground level, and we teach them when we come in the door. So this community connection is that we have. We're an integral part of the community, and I'm proud to be associated with a company like this. Now, I'd like to ask a representative or the whole table for the following sponsors that I'd like to recognize. If you could hold your applause to the end, that would be great. We'll get everybody recognized, and then we'll have a giant round of applause. But first, let's get some folks from Bluestone Bank to stand up, please. Anybody from Bluestone Bank? There we go. Stand up, please. If you can stand up and stay standing, that'd be great. Next, Good Samaritan Medical Center. Okay. What are we doing over there? Harbor One Bank. Thank you. Lynch & Lynch. I think I saw. There he is, Andrew. National Grid. Anybody from National Grid? Okay. And last but not least, Rockland Trust. I know I saw a few people from Rockland. There we go. So these are event sponsors today. So please give them a giant round of applause for their commitment. Okay, as far as sponsors go, last but not least, I would like to thank Bridgewater State University. We've done many events here, but the past couple of years, you know, we haven't. Their commitment to the United Way has been outstanding. Lots of support over the years, and I'd like to give the BSU president, Fred Clark, a round of applause while he comes up here. And he's going to say a few words.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Welcome, everyone, to Bridgewater State University. We are so delighted, truly, to see everyone once again, all of our friends from the United Way of Greater Plymouth County, at your annual meeting. I want to recognize our good friend, Dennis Carman, who I didn't recognize with a ponytail, and all of his amazing staff for the great work that they do. I also want to thank our BSU team here, the President's Office, University Events, and all of our friends from Bridgewater Dining, who will serve you the great lunch that you're about to have. I want to also, on behalf of the university, congratulate all of the award recipients for your truly impactful contributions to this region and beyond. As we celebrate this 100th annual meeting, as the chairman said, we look back, and it's not lost. It's a bit ironic that 100 years ago at the first annual meeting, our nation had just emerged from a deadly global pandemic. Our nation had just emerged from a horrific land war in Europe. Those are just two challenges. We faced many more today. But then, as now, the hottest fires forge the strongest steel. And instead of being ground down by the immense challenges, the most resilient, adaptable, mission-driven organizations stepped up when we needed them the most. And like the United Way of Plymouth County, somehow those organizations, your organizations, became stronger, even in the face of adversity. For our part here at BSU, when our employees and our students needed us the most, we protected every single job. We provided more than $25 million worth of emergency funding for our students. And we're proud to say that our COVID response was so effective, 96% of our campus was and is fully vaccinated, and we did not lose one single member of our 12,000-person campus community to the virus. Not one. Thank you. Thank you. We did a lot more, but briefly, we pushed the university forward by doing $30 million worth of projects and securing another $50 million worth of facility upgrades. We also added a childhood studies major in our very first engineering program in partnership with our friends at Stonehill College in photonics and optical engineering. And finally, we're in the last stages of launching a cybersecurity program as well. As you'll hear today, the United Way of Greater Plymouth County stepped up for our region so beautifully as well, proving once again in its 100-year history that our United Way remains resilient, adaptable, and driven courageously forward by its noble mission and noble purpose. And for that, we're truly honored to host today's event, and we remain deeply, deeply grateful to be your partner. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, President Clark. Okay, this is where I go off script. Some more recognition. I would be remiss if I didn't recognize, if we could get Dennis and the entire United Way team, and also the board of directors, if you could all stand for a big round of applause for everything you do. It's an unbelievable team to work with, current board members, former board members. The amount of passion that, you know, ends up in that room or on that Zoom screen for the past 2 years is just unbelievable. And I will just say I'm proud to work with everybody at this amazing organization. Next, I'd like to bring up Joe Camise. Joe is our chair of the governance committee. He's been working tirelessly on new board members, which he's going to introduce new board members, the board officers for next year, and retiring board members. Joe is also our treasurer, and you know, it's been a tough couple years. He's put in a lot of work behind the scenes, and I can't say enough about what he does. Thank you, Joe.
Thank you. Good afternoon. I'd be amiss if I did not first do one of my jobs as chairman of the governance committee. We are always looking for new board members. And if anyone, and I mean anyone, is interested I would like to talk to them or to Dr. Dennis, and we can place you on the board. It is the most rewarding, and I think it's fun. You enjoy it. Once a month is not bad at all. And that put aside, then I will proceed. From the present board, we have the following resigning and retiring members. The individuals who are leaving, they've done an excellent job. They have other responsibilities, and they're going forward. Greg Howell from Flexible Concepts, Joseph Cardinal, National Grid, Peter Del Russo, Bluestone Bank. I'd like to hear applause for them, please. At this time, I would like to call out our new members of the board and would ask that they stand after I say their name. If you could hold your applause till after they're all standing, I'd appreciate it. Evelyn Lee from the Boston Renaissance Charter Public School. I guess she here? Nope. Narzine Shabli, I hope I pronounced that correctly, from Bridgewater State University. Tracy Rosebrook from Stonehill College. Alyssa Alley from Ocean Spray. And Courtney Tilton from Bluestone Bank. And at this time also, I'd like all the board members to please stand. And I'd like to have a round of applause for all the members. Please be seated. I'd like to announce the board officers. Before I do, I want to mention that the entire board of directors asked the present officers if they would extend their another year, and they all agreed with the challenges we have been going through for the past 2 years. We still have many, many challenges before us, and this board of officers have proven their worth. The board of officers are John Doyle. Please stand when I call your name. UPS Board Chair. Andrew Lynch from Lynch & Lynch Law Firm, Vice Chair. Joseph Camise, American Bookkeeping Solutions, myself, Treasurer. And Carol Martin, Harbor One Bank, Secretary, Clerk. Thank you, and I appreciate everybody extending. At this time, I'd like to call Dennis Karin to introduce our special video presentations and video testimonies. Thank you.
Hello again. I've noticed that you folks either don't follow directions very well or you're a bunch of rebels. I think I'll treat you as a bunch of rebels. I like that better. Thank you. You clap whenever you want. You don't listen to people tell you to. We are so blessed with the following presentation that we're going to put up. A number of you in this room and a number of people outside of this room had agreed to do testimonials for our United Way. If you follow our Facebook page, you would have likely seen some or all of these. When we put together the compilation, we weren't able to put every one of them back together because some of you did such a great job and had so many nice things to say. We thought it might be a little overkill, but truth of it is we are just so thankful for the different people and the different perspectives that people have regarding our 100th year. So at this time, I would direct your attention to the screens and for this special testimonial.
Happy 100th birthday, United Way of Greater Plymouth County. We are so proud to do this work with you and to help support our communities. Here's to the next 100 years.
Cien años seré, cien años seré, feliz cumpleaños, United Way, cien años seré, san hooray, san. Nationals, hooray. Nice and loud. 100 years, hooray. 100 years, hooray. Happy birthday, United Way. 100 years, hooray. Everything you do. Woo!
Happy 100th anniversary to the United Way of Greater Plymouth County. What a tremendous milestone this is as the United Way celebrates 100 years of service to the people, families, and organizations of our shared local community. Stonehill College has been a proud partner of the United Way for many years, aligned in our efforts to create a more just and compassionate world. Stonehill students and graduates have interned or worked at the United Way. We've partnered in and outside of the classroom through community-based learning and service opportunities. And we have co-hosted programs and events. These are just a few of the many ways that Stonehill and the United Way have built a strong relationship over these years. It is my honor to recognize and congratulate the United Way for your tremendous commitment to the vibrancy and strength of our shared local community. Today, we stand alongside you as a friend and partner as you celebrate 100 years. We look forward to working with you for many years to come. Congratulations and happy anniversary.
Hi, I'm Bill McCann. I'm a senior vice president at Wells Fargo Advisors. And I wanted to wish our friends at United Way of Greater Plymouth County a happy 100th birthday. Our company believes in giving back to the communities in which we live and work. And for the last 100 years, the United Way of Greater Plymouth County has been a great option for doing exactly that.
Hello, I'm Scott Sanborn, Chief Lending Officer for Harbor One Bank. Thank you, United Way of Greater Plymouth County, for a century of caring for our community. Harbor One and United Way of Greater Plymouth County share a passion for helping our neighbors find solutions to their most urgent needs. Again, happy 100th birthday to United Way of Greater Plymouth County.
Happy birthday, United Way of Greater Plymouth County. Welcome to the Century Club with Harbor One Bank. My name is Carol Martin, and I'm proud to be a board member of the United Way and also the co-chair of the Community Impact Committee. The great work that we do in the community through the allocations process is just incredible, and everyone, we appreciate your donations to support the community. So happy birthday.
Happy birthday to the United Way of Greater Plymouth County. At Harbor One, we really love volunteering for the United Way every year. We know that our contributions stay local and that they help our friends and neighbors who really need them most. So happy birthday and have a great year.
Hello, my name is Tanya Medeiros. I'm a loan officer assistant for the lending division of Harbor One Mortgage. It has been such a pleasure working alongside with the United Way of Greater Plymouth County in allocating funds to organizations that help so many families in our community in need. Thank you, United Way, for everything that you do, and happy 100th birthday.
Happy birthday, United Way.
Hello, my name is John Yazwinski from Father Bill's in Mainspring. I want to say congratulations to the United Way of Plymouth County for over 100 years of helping people in our community, making our community a strong and vibrant place, welcome for everybody in need. I want to also thank all the companies and organizations that every year, over the last 100 years, have continued to support the United Way's mission to help people in the community in need. And lastly, I want to say thank you to Dennis Carman, a true leader, a coalition builder. Thank you for your partnership and your friendship. Again, congratulations, best wishes, United Way of Plymouth County.
Hello, United Way of Greater Plymouth County. This is Robert Sullivan, Mayor of the City of Brockton, the City of Champs, and I just wanted to extend my congratulations on 100 years of service, 100 years, a century. Improving the lives of everyone here in the City of Brockton and throughout Plymouth County. Your efforts have really strengthened all of the communities within Plymouth County because they offer solutions based upon really your understanding of the local needs, the individual needs within the municipality. So as mayor of the great city of Champions, I can tell you that I can see how the United Way of Greater Plymouth County transforms the lives of city residents each and every day. Your dedication to education and public health and individual financial stability truly benefits the person and the community as a whole. So I can look back at from Brockton Day Nursery, Brockton Visiting Nurse Associations, really everyone in the city of Champions is indebted to your efforts. So your volunteer-based model is a true inspiration. When Brocktonians here in the city see your generosity at work, we're truly motivated, from the 400 cozy, warm children's coats and the local blood drives to the generous funding you provided for over 30 social programs. Your presence is felt here in the city of Brockton each and every day.
Happy 100th birthday to our friends at United Way of Greater Plymouth County. Thank you for a century of caring for the people who live and work in your community. My name is Milton Little. I am the president and CEO of United Way of Greater Atlanta and the former president and CEO of United Way of Mass Bay and Merrimack Valley, where I became incredibly familiar with the proud legacy and community impact of your United Way. My dear friend and colleague, Dennis Carman, is as passionate a United Way professional leader as you will find in our global network. The combination of his leadership, the volunteers and staff he supports, and the companies, employees, and others who support United Way of Greater Plymouth County embody the best of the county's can-do spirit when it comes to finding solutions for the community's most urgent needs. The guiding precepts of your United Way, volunteer-led, local, solutions-focused, relationship and partnership-centric, are the reasons you've had such consistent and enduring impact for a century. You have much to celebrate as you look back on 100 years of service, and like you, I believe the best is yet to come. Congratulations again to United Way of Greater Plymouth County for a century of service and impact.
On behalf of Bridgewater State University, I want to express my deepest gratitude to the United Way of Greater Plymouth County on the occasion of its centennial celebration. For 100 years, you have been bringing people, knowledge, and resources together to serve the needs of our brothers and sisters in this region. In the process, you have built stronger communities, forged a shared sense of responsibility, and fostered awareness of how much we have in common and how much we need each other. At BSU, we greatly value our relationship with the United Way, joined together by a shared sense of purpose to serve, to minister unto. Thank you also to our friend Dennis Carman, who embodies the ideal of the selfless servant leader. We are truly blessed to know and to work with you, Dennis. Congratulations again to the United Way of Greater Plymouth for all that you do.
Wow, 100 years. Congratulations, United Way of Greater Plymouth County. Brockton Trust is honored to help you celebrate this remarkable milestone. What an extraordinary legacy you've built by supporting and caring for individuals and families throughout our community. The bank's longtime partnership with United Way has helped us make a profound difference for our neighbors in need. Through our corporate giving program and volunteerism, Brockton Trust colleagues have been able to contribute to the life-changing services you provide for over 30 years. The work of the United Way of Greater Plymouth County continues to inspire us and bring deeper meaning to the work we do. With your help, we'll be able to strengthen the communities in which we live and work and build relationships that will last a lifetime. Happy 100th anniversary from Brockton Trust.
Hey there, it's Derek Hine, President and CEO of Boys and Girls Clubs of Metro South. I am so happy to celebrate United Way of Plymouth County's 100 years of caring for our community. The kids of our club are so lucky to have an amazing partner in our local United Way to provide them with the programs, services, and life-changing resources to be successful in the Brockton community and beyond. Thank you, United Way of Greater Plymouth County, for a century of caring for our community.
Congratulate United Way of Greater Plymouth County on celebrating 100 years of caring for the communities there. What a huge accomplishment, I'm telling you. Here's to the next 100 years of working together to unite people, ideas, and resources to improve the lives and to build a stronger community. Because as you know, we can't do it alone, and we shouldn't do it alone. We can't, okay? So if we could, we would have, right? So we need places like United Way. We need churches like Pastor and the First Lady Gilbert churches that I call them in the trenches type of churches. You know, we need these things because we are the community together. Those of us that's out there struggling, those of us that's on the other side, we need to come together. I always say providers and survivors got to do it together. So I'm coming out there. I'm excited. I do a lot of work with different United Ways. So what United Way is doing there in Plymouth County, guys, I'm telling you, it's not done in a lot of other places. So congratulations again.
Hey, this is Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker, and I'm honored to be with you all, even if it's virtually, to celebrate the 100th birthday of our friends at United Way of Greater Plymouth County. We're glad to support United Way and its team, as you all have had a real, tangible impact on your community. You truly live up to your mission of improving lives. We're so grateful for your commitment and your dedication to your communities and the ones that need the help the most. I want to thank you for all that you do, and I want to thank you for your generous supporters who make your work possible. I also want to say how much we appreciate our partnership with you, and we're very proud of the United Way of Greater Plymouth County. Congratulations again on 100 years of getting it done for the people of Plymouth County. Congratulations.
I repeat, we are so thankful for those folks who took the time and made the effort to send us such wonderful messages. I can only say that all of the kind statements that were made about me personally in those videos, it only cost a second mortgage on my house, just so you know. And in regards to my ponytail, President Clark, I can only say this. I will no longer make fun of any hair conditioner commercials for the ladies to make sure there are no tangles in your hair. I'm not making any of those jokes anymore. Thank you. Really, what a wonderful, wonderful time. At this time, because what we do here very often is to thank all of the organizations and the individuals that have been supportive of us, particularly through trying to raise resources through several years of a pandemic. So at this time, I am honored to call to the podium Laura Murphy, who is our Director of Resource Development, and two gentlemen who had agreed to be this year's United Way campaign co-chairs, Mr. Bill McCann, who's actually done it five times in his career and ours, and from Wells Fargo, and then Scott Sanborn, who has done it for three consecutive years from Harbor One. We bring these folks up in front of you to offer our thanks and indebtedness to all of the companies who ran such terrific campaigns.
Thank you, Dennis. And it's so great to see everybody here in person. Before we get started in all the fun stuff, I just want to take this opportunity to thank Bill and Scott for your leadership during this 100th campaign anniversary. It's been another challenging year, but we're extremely fortunate for your expertise, your dedication, and your support to our United Way. And we also appreciate how you're both characters with great senses of humor that have helped us get us through some tough days. So thank you very much.
Well, thank you, Laura, and we'll try to keep it as fast as possible. I'm both honored and thrilled to be serving our community in this capacity. Along with Bill, I wouldn't have come back if it weren't for Bill, but in all seriousness, I can't think of a better person to work with. This has been a year that's been challenging in so many ways. However, we have another year where community leaders have demonstrated their generosity and influence to help make the campaign a success so we can help our neighbors in need. Turn it over to Bill.
Thanks, Scott. When we take into account the new and continuing local corporate giving, workplace campaigns, as well as individual giving, we've raised over $800,000 so far this year. On behalf of Dennis and his team at the United Way, I would like to acknowledge and thank the organizations, agencies, individuals for your commitment to United Way and our shared communities. Without any further delay, we would like to announce the 2021-2022 United Way of Greater Plymouth County Campaign Awards.
Thank you both. So in efforts to support our solution-based strategies to reimagine and rebuild our community, we often seek the help of our local community leaders to provide additional resources to meet the increased needs of our calls for help from our local neighbors in need. In responding to those local needs, our focus remains on the critical concerns of feeding our families, housing and homelessness, access to affordable health services, support for our children and youth, support for job training and job placement, and diversity, equity, and inclusion. And net proceeds from our Live United Fund are used to help these urgent recovery initiatives at our partner agencies. And you can be assured that when you give to the Live United Fund, your dollars are stay locally and are distributed to the programs with the most impact on our vulnerable neighbors. And this process is driven by 50 allocation volunteer panelists who give their time and their expertise, and they ensure that the donations to the funds are distributed to the programs that provide the most impact in our local community. So thank you so much to all our volunteer allocations panelists. All right, let's get started. So our first award is called the Corporate Champion for Change Award and is in recognition for a company whose actions underscore their commitment to the community. And this year, that award goes to McGovern Automotive Group. McGovern is a brand new relationship to our United Way, and we are so thankful for their significant contribution to our Warmer Winters initiative, which provides toasty coats to children in need. When we asked them for a donation to Warmer Winters this year, they generously responded with 10 times the amount that we had asked. And we are so thankful that their Brockton franchise invests some of their resources in supporting their local community. And we certainly look forward to the continued partnership, and we thank them. So a big congratulations. Unfortunately, they aren't able to make it today, so I will accept this award on their behalf. But thank you, and congratulations to McGovern Automotive Group.
Scott, this is an honor to be able to announce this next award. This is our Circle of Caring Award for the largest corporate gift to the Live United Fund. I'm happy to share that the award for the third year in a row goes to Harbor One Bank. Harbor One is also one of our annual meeting sponsors again this year. Harbor One continues to honor and embrace its commitment to strengthen and empower the communities where their employees live and work. So thank you so much, Jim Blake, Joe Casey, Carol, Scott, Jen, Deb, Eric, and your whole Harbor One team for your tremendous support, and congratulations again.
Well, it seems every year I get this honor, and I very much appreciate this opportunity. The next award we're announcing goes to an incredibly impressive organization. I'm referring to Rockland Trust. This year, Rockland Trust is being recognized for having the largest employee campaign. They do it year in and year out, so thank you, Rockland Trust. Also, as I said, for the third year in a row. Rockland Trust is also one of our event sponsors. They're committed to our communities, as everyone has seen, on a regular basis, and been a leading supporter of our United Way for many years. A big shout out and thank you to Chris Oldlifson, Jim Smith, Ed Segrew, Barbara Cowgill, and Deidre Perry for your leadership, and to your team for all the support and generosity. Congratulations. We could list a number of other Rockland Trust staff who have supported our United Way throughout the years because you're all so amazing. So if you would Jim and Ed come to the podium to receive the award from Laura, and let's give them a big round of applause.
So our next award is our Circle of Caring Employee Campaign Manager Award. And this award is given to the campaign managers in recognition of their significant contribution to the campaign. But before I announce these two awardees, I just want to take the opportunity to thank all of our employee campaign managers who, in addition to their everyday responsibilities, take on the task of running their employee campaign at their businesses and agencies. So thank you. And when we meet with staff and company leadership, we suggest that employee campaign manager is someone who is well-liked, organized, trusted, and has a can-do attitude. And for those reasons, our two awardees, our first being Amy Cameron Bennett from Brockton Visiting Nurses Association. Amy's support and commitment helped drive a record-high employee campaign for BVNA. Amy also helped coordinate an in-person meeting, allowing me to talk to their staff about their contribution and their impact in the local community, which we all know makes a huge difference. Amy is always available, eager, and willing to help our United Way in any way she can, and she attends many of our events, which are kickoff in the fall here today, and as many as well. We're so thankful for you, Amy, and congratulations on this well-deserved award, and please come to the podium to accept. Our second Employee Campaign Manager Award goes to Kathy Baldwin from the Arc of Plymouth in Upper Cape Cod. Kathy joined us this year as a new Employee Campaign Manager, filling in for a colleague last minute. And Kathy really stepped up to the plate and even extended the campaign 1 week to make sure she could make personal asks to her leadership team, which ultimately increased the campaign from the previous year. Kathy was more than willing to join me at a meeting in Plymouth at one of our local hotels to talk about the great programs the ARCs have that are funded by United Way funding. Thank you so much, Kathy, for all you do for our United Way. We appreciate your support and everything you do. Congratulations, and please come up and accept your award.
Bill, I don't know what's more impressive, you and I being able to dodge each other as we go through this program or not tripping on the cords. It's my pleasure to introduce our next award, which is a recognition for the best nonprofit campaign. I know this individual well. This award goes to Father Bill's in Mainspring. They had their best campaign ever this year. John Yaswinski and his team allowed Laura, Dennis, and Lisa to join their leadership team meeting to talk about the impact the campaign has on our communities. We certainly appreciate their partnership over the years. Also, a special thank you to Lynn Colling for her leadership and first year leadership as their employee campaign manager. We appreciate your support and dedication to making your campaign a huge success. Thank you to John and your incredible staff for your continued support and partnership. Do you have an award for John?
Yes.
Is John here? Yep. Oh, all right, the team's coming up. Come on up.
Our last award is our Live United Chairman's Award, and it's in recognition of a company's commitment to our United Way and the community. This award goes to a longstanding supporter of our United Way. In addition to a successful workplace campaign, this company gives a significant corporate gift to our Live United Fund. They are also always there for our neighbors, helping keep us powered up and safe in all kinds of weather at all types of hours of the day and night. In addition, they are also one of our annual meeting sponsors for the second year in a row. This award goes to National Grid. Thank you, Joe Cardinal, for your leadership and to the staff for their support. Congratulations. Our friends at National Grid staff cannot be with us today as they have an important regional team meeting and are unable to be here with us. Laura will accept the award on their behalf. Let's have a nice round of applause for National Grid.
All right. A huge thank you to our United Way supporters and community partners for your dedication to our community initiatives and the families we serve. You are here for us even when there's obstacles in place. And we thank you for that, and we certainly could not do it without all of you in this room. And again, Bill and Scott, thank you so much for your leadership and your dedication. Just have a little something for you guys as a thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much for all you do. And again, lastly, we'll just have another round of applause for all of our supporters here in this room. Thank you so much. And at this time, I will turn things back over to Dennis Carmen. Thank you so much.
I don't know if you know this, but the real entertainment is supposed to be one of the times I'm going back and forth next to all these fragile signs is that I'm going to take them all out at one point. It's really going to happen. Just trust me on this one. At this point, we thought it would be really an important thing to do, because 100 years is significant, as our chair had mentioned at the beginning, and we want to embrace that, and we want to also couple that with the thought that we're always thankful at United Way, and we're always offering our thanks to all of those organizations that do the work, all those companies that raise the dollars, all the volunteers. So at this point, I'm going to be asking our longtime United Way, a staunch United Way supporter, and I know this because I've gone on the campaign trail with her, and she is, and I mean this with all the love in my heart, she is a brutal United Way campaigner. She gets out there, and she gets in your face, and so if you don't want to run a successful United Way campaign by yourselves, I'm going to send her your way. And trust me, she will get it done. I want Elaine Reiser, 40-plus years working as a community partner with BAMSI, founder of the Helpline, all of you are familiar with, I am sure, and just an all-around one of those people that I look to as a mentor to offer a community toast.
Thank you, Dennis. It's so nice to see so many familiar faces out in the audience. Please join me in a toast by pouring that delicious Ocean Spray juice on your table. And if you look for it, you'll find it. Please pour your juice into your keepsake United Way wine glasses and raise them high so we can take a few pictures. Please join me in this toast as we stand here today celebrating 100 years of caring for our community. We must acknowledge that our United Way's first century of working to improve the lives of our neighbors who are most in need would not have been possible without our corporate sponsors, our leadership givers, our volunteers, our compassionate community partners, and our community leaders. So here's to you, our United Way of Plymouth County's community.
You know, I'm so glad that you didn't pick this moment to clap at the same time with a weird... Thank you. Thank you, Elaine. And I wasn't going to say this, but, you know, one of the reasons we asked Elaine to do the toast is we think she can drink any of you under the table, just so you know. All right. We are lucky today. We have the Brockton mayor is in the house. So the Honorable Robert Sullivan is with us today, and we would be remiss if we didn't give the mayor an opportunity to come up and say hello.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I want to thank Dennis and his team at United Way. When you think about 100 years, I mean, that's an unbelievable milestone. I want to thank Bridgewater State and President Clark for hosting this beautiful event. There's so many folks here today that have collaborated over the years, not just for the city of Brockton, but the towns in the region and Plymouth County as a whole and the Commonwealth. And one thing I can tell you is I took office as mayor January 6th of 2020. COVID-19 hadn't even come here yet. It was still actually overseas in Italy at that time. But we knew it was coming. And I knew as mayor I needed to somehow forge a relationship, a financial benefit. So we created the Brockton Together Fund. United Way was the first organization to jump in and support that. I'll never forget that. So thank you, United Way. In terms of all the award recipients today, I want to say thank you. Thank you for what you do each and every day in your respective endeavors. We are always better together, right? We know that. And I think if COVID has taught us anything, we've changed, right? Financially, mentally, emotionally. It's changed all of us, right? I'm a dad of three kids. My title is mayor. My job is dad and husband. But I can tell you right now, when I look out, I just see dedicated public servants. Doesn't matter if you lead a city of Brockton or you lead a university or you lead United Way. We do it because we're in the people business. And every single day we try to make a difference in the lives of people. And that's what United Way does. So as mayor and as a Brocktonian, I just want to look at all of you and say thank you. But our job isn't done. We have to continue to roll up our sleeves. City of Brockton is called the City of Champions for a reason. And United Way and all the sponsors and all the partners are champions in your own right. So let's continue to work together for the better of the Commonwealth and the county and our nation as a whole. God bless each and every one of you. Thank you.
All right, folks. This is the part of the program that usually drags out the longest because I'm up here. I'll do my best to fight down all of those urges to go off script, okay? Even though the reality is at this point, this section of the meeting and the program is our community impact section, where we thank all of those volunteers and people who are in critical positions that have done a tremendous service to our community at large. So let me begin by starting with some of the really impressive awards. Our community impact awards this year are all in the areas of health for obvious reasons, because we're certainly still in the throes of a pandemic, and we might be on the other side, but the reality is there are still people who are struggling and suffering, and we need to be careful about that. So we begin with a true advocate for health and really one of the nicest and most energetic people I know, Barbara Cotton, who is the executive director of the American Red Cross of Southeastern Massachusetts, Cape and the Islands. And Barbara is an absolute dynamo. She is always in motion. She has always got a smile. The American Red Cross, as most of you know, certainly look for your donations for blood. But what you may not know is that we are and have been at a critical juncture, a critical level in our blood supply, which means we don't have barely a day's supply of blood for our hospitals and healthcare facilities. So the United Way teamed up with Barbara and her team in order to put on three blood drives where we got 102 different donations of blood that will absolutely affect the lives of 300 people, 3-1. Every time you donate blood, there are three people who benefit, and we've done that as our way of contributing in our 100th year. We wanted to hit at least 100 donors, and we did that. But beyond that, the American Red Cross also does health programs They do training for CPR. They do training for lifeguards. They do a wonderful program regarding smoke detectors called Sound the Alarm. And if you look at the heart of the American Red Cross, there's health there. If you also look at the American Red Cross of southeastern Massachusetts, you will find Barbara Cotton there. So will Barbara Cotton come and receive this year's United Way Community Impact and Health Award?
I'd be remiss if I walked by a microphone and didn't stop and take a moment to just say thank you so very much. The entire team here at the United Way is absolutely amazing, but Dennis and Kim, I am so proud to call you not just colleagues, but friends, really and truly. When the 100 year was in the making, he reached out to me and said, how can I help to make an impact? And of course, Dennis always being one to say, like, how can I double what we're gonna do? He says a blood drive because it's the 3-to-1. So he's not kidding when 102 units really helped 306 people. So thank you for tripling the impact. Really. Thank you.
Thank you, Barbara. Our second award recipient, no less important and no less energetic, the mayor asked John Messier to spearhead the Health Equity Task Force and the efforts of the city of Brockton in order to battle the pandemic. Because as you know, any urban center has been struggling mightily in order to keep the vaccination rates high and the boosters high and the incidence of people contracting the illness and also those people dying from the illness. And John Messier is that person and has done a phenomenal job in a very down-to-earth way. He reaches out in order to connect the healthcare professionals, the nonprofit world, and the churches and all of the folks in the community in order to make sure that we can be as effective as we can to keep those numbers in that urban center where they need to be. And I can say with pride that Brockton has its vaccination rate up to 70%, and they're doing a terrific job of trying to make sure that people are continuing to get their boosters and doing a great job. But John Messier, please come to the podium and receive again a Community Impact and Health Award.
Thank you, Dennis. Thank you, United Way. Happy anniversary on the 100th year. I want to say it's a true blessing to be able to work with somebody like Dennis and the United Way and all the collaboration there is in this room and in Plymouth County. It's a tremendous impact for me just in my life to see lives change. I am blessed to be able to work for Mayor Sullivan, the city of Brockton, and be able to just make this change happen. I look forward to the continuing successes in the future and what we can do to blossom and improve the communities and the cities around us. Thank you very much. Thank you, guys.
Our third award in the area of community impact and health. As the pandemic has gone on, we have become much more aware that in addition to the physical challenges that people are going through, they're going through other challenges. And the area of mental health has come to light. We have had a mental health series of issues for many years that I would say we've been under affecting. We have not made the impacts we need to make. We're under-resourced. And during the pandemic, it became much more clear that we've got mental health issues that we need to be dealing with. We are fortunate in the greater Plymouth area to have someone like the National Alliance on Mental Illness, and its chapter head is Sheila Flaherty, who's been doing terrific work in order to make all of us more aware of taking away the stigma about mental health, saying it's okay to talk about, saying it is important for us to have the important resources there. She and all of her volunteers had developed something called the Roadmap of Resources for Mental Health Services and has done a fantastic job. So we wanted to shine a little bit more of a light on the need to continue to address our mental health issues as a community. Would Sheila Flaherty, local head of NAMI, please come forward and receive United Way's Community Impact and Health Award. There you go. Come on. All right, you're going to make me show that I'm not left-handed now.
Wow.
Step to this side.
Hi, thank you so much. NAMI Plymouth is so honored to be recognized. We're all volunteers. It's the largest grassroots organization. We have a lot of support out there, more so now since the pandemic. A lot of support groups for family members, people affected by mental illness, friends. It's a good group. So check us out, NAMI Mass website. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. Just going to hold this award for my own inspiration, but the good news is I really don't have to read this one because I can do this more from memory. This next award is called our Community Spirit Award, and it really goes to the person or persons who've really made a difference in terms of their volunteerism. You're lucky enough to have met one of the two people, and I think you're going to be even luckier to meet both of the people who I'm referring to, because we're referring to our own John Doyle, our board chair, and his lovely wife, Courtney, who together form really one of the perfect examples of a power couple that I've ever seen. As John has served on our board of directors and the last 3 years as our board chair, what's really endearing about John is that John will go out and get excited about cleaning trash in Brockton. I mean, you know, he got his fellow UPSers all to roll up their sleeves and to get some garbage bags, and to really, the year that I remember going out with him on the streets, they were like delighted. It was amazing to watch them attack the trash as they, you know, carefully deliver your packages. So it was like they were wrestling with the trash, but they're taking the best care of your packages at UPS because, you know, Brown is, you know, the best, right? Brown is the best. But John can't do what he's doing if he doesn't have the support of a terrific spouse, significant other, whatever the terminology is today. Courtney, I apologize, because to be honest with you, I just say hero, and you know that should cover it all. But Courtney herself is involved in a lot of great causes, and too numerous to mention, the one that really stands out to me is that she ran the Boston Marathon while she had flu-like symptoms. And I'm like, I'm amazed that, A, you even think about running the Boston Marathon, because I get tired just thinking about it. And then to have you run it is one thing, but to have you run it and not be well and complete it is amazing. All for a good cause, all for a charity, if she was out there for. And what's really, to me, amazing is while she's doing this, supporting John, doing her own charitable goods, she's launched a wonderful business called the Clandestine Kitchen. And if you're into health food, and I have to say I'm not always, green food to me is pistachio ice cream or mint chocolate chip, right? But I can say I've actually sampled the goods of the Clandestine Kitchen, and it's healthy and it's good. I had a Southwest salad that was one of the best salads, and I don't tell my friends that I ever said this about a salad, the best salad I'd ever had. So for all of those reasons and many more that we can't go into because we don't have the time, would Courtney and John Doyle come up and receive this year's Community Spirit Award from the United Way of Greater Plymouth County?
So you've heard enough from me already. I do want you to hear from my better half for a second, because I thought I was involved with the community until I saw what she does behind the scenes, and it's amazing. So,
I'll let you say a few words. She's talking. There you go.
Thank you so much. I'm looking at this giant font that you're reading from, Dennis. It's really impressive. I need to get this for John for next time. I just want to take a moment just to say this is amazing and thank you so much, but we are in such amazing company today. My company, Clandestine Kitchen, our company, we recognize a lot of you from other community events and other community philanthropic efforts that we're involved in, be that Father Bill's Wellspring, be that Rockland Trust, you guys are everywhere. We are also President Circle members for South Shore Health. And so recently, since 2020, we've really dedicated a lot of our financial resources as a company to helping to support the Graykin Center at South Shore Health, which addresses behavioral health issues as well as substance use disorder. So we've been very proud for that. And United Way has been an incredible inspiration for me as a small business owner, for John as being involved in a larger company who is very rooted in giving back. It's very much a part of who we are, and I know it's very much a part of who all of you are. And from the bottom of my heart, and I know I can speak for John saying the same, thank you so much for all that you do for everyone in our communities, us coming together and working together to make a difference and make an impact. That's the only way that we can do it, especially now. So thank you very much, and congratulations to everybody in the room. Thank you.
Stay right here. I have to ask John and Courtney to stay right here because our friends at UPS have something else they would like to do.
This is off script.
We're off script,
John. Just a little bit, yes.
All right, so on behalf of UPS, we want to thank John and Courtney Doyle as well for not only leading by example in the community, but also with their companies and the stuff that they do. They definitely guide each one of us that work for them to make sure that we put it as a forefront to give back to our communities and get involved. So we just want to thank you.
So all the way from Dallas, Texas, I just want to recognize the fact that your impact doesn't just affect this community. You touch the nation. He touches in this couple. They touch so many people across the nation in how they lead, how they serve, how hard they work, and how successful you've been doing it all. The picture of humility is inspiring, and you set the bar high, both of you. It's an honor to be here. It's an honor to work with you and to know you both. Thank you.
The next award is an absolute honor for me to offer, an honor for the United Way to offer. It is a Lifetime Community Impact Award, and it shouldn't surprise anybody in this room, given the high caliber of people, any number of you could expect an award like this, but it just so happens that our friend and inspiration, Jim Blake, is retiring, as some of you know. Jim Blake and Harbor One have been an absolute staple in our community and specifically for our United Way. Year in and year out, they do successful United Way campaigns, but the impact of Harbor One goes so far beyond what the United Way is and does, and it affects many of our community partners here and the community at large. Jim has just set the tone. He is the classiest person I know. And for many, many years of knowing him, in some levels, as friendly and kind as he is, he intimidates me. I don't know. I'm just going to be honest about that because he does. And I have I could go on and on about all that Harbor One and Jim have done, but I want to tell two quick stories. One is, a number of years ago, I was practicing what we call in the nonprofit world and even the business world, your 90-second elevator speech. You know what those are? You remember what those are? You know, you're going to brag about what the company is you do. You're going to impress the socks off of somebody about what you do. So I had worked on my United Way elevator speech, and I had delivered it in front of a campaign meeting one morning. And Jim, you know, and I'm saying things like, the United Way is a community convener. It builds capacity in the community. It builds partnerships. It really does such tremendous work. And Jim patiently listened to me, waited a heartbeat until I finished, and then said, that's nice, Dennis, but people don't care about any of that. And of course, I'm like floored, right? I'm like, here's one of my inspirations. And then he said, what they care about is pulling on the heartstrings. What they care about is the people that you're going to be helping. Tell those stories. And I'm going to have you keep that thought in your mind, because when we move to the next award and the final one in this series, I think you'll know what Jim's words would ring true. But the second thing I want to say is, when I called Jim up to explain we wanted to honor him in this way, he said, you know, I'm honored and thank you. But then he said, I want to tell you that the next night I'm going to be attending the President's Dinner at Stonehill College, and they're going to be honoring me. And I would totally understand if you didn't want to honor me knowing that. What a class act, huh? I mean, to say, gee, we don't want to, you know, if you don't have to do that. And I said, you know, Jim, there aren't enough awards that we could give you that would reflect how much we appreciate the impact that you and Harbor One have had in our community. So would Jim Blake kindly come to the podium and receive this year's United Way of Greater Plymouth County Lifetime Community Impact Award.
Just a thank you and congratulations to 100 years. Congratulations to everyone that's here, all of the organizations in the community that participate and help in the work that has benefited the United Way and the people that are there. And I want to, in particular, thank our 650 staff and the thousands of donations they give in terms of time in the marketplace to help as well. So thank you.
Thank you, Jim, again, for all you do. And thank you, Harbor One, for leading and following this man's wonderful example. We need more and more people like that in our community, and thank you. We've got a room full of them. You need to go out and get 10 more each, okay? Just, that's your job, about 10 more. The final award in this category is what we call the Profile in Courage Award, and it's really given to a person who's taken advantage of a United Way-funded program, one of our community partners. And this year's partner that we deal with is the School on Wheels of Massachusetts. And I'm going to actually, because I want to do justice to this story, I'm actually going to take the unprecedented step of reading this, because it will be better than me fumbling through trying to remember all the details. As I hope you all know, School on Wheels of Massachusetts offers programs that provide academic support for students impacted by homelessness within our communities. Supported with United Way funding, their mentoring program provides guidance, encouragement, and support for at-risk older students as they navigate post-secondary education and/or vocational training. We understand that Shantaria was skeptical about being paired with a mentor, convinced that a mentor, too, would leave her. 7 years later, 7 years later, the unbreakable bond between Shantaria and her mentor, Lori Brown, continues. Quote, "I wish I had known about School on Wheels when I was younger," Shantaria said. Shantaria has overcome unspeakable obstacles, yet with Lori by her side, she has soared. She says that the pandemic helped her flourish. While battling health issues, Shantaria was able to maintain her studies remotely, navigate a virtual internship with School on Wheels, become chair of the youth forum at Raising Multicultural Kids, and complete a fellowship at the Bridgewater State University Martin Richard Institute for Social Justice. The Black Lives Matter movement inspired her to use her story and voice to advocate for racial justice. She is a member of the Greater Boston Association of Black Social Workers. Quote, "What she needed was a friend," unquote, said her mentor, Lori. Quote, "I will always be there for her. She inspires me." After graduating last year from BSU, Shantaria is now part of the School on Wheels family, working with students as a site coordinator. Her success and achievements are a testament to her determination, hard work, and what can happen with a little help from friends. Additional congratulations are apparently in order, as Shantaria was recently married on Saturday, May 21st. Shantaria, if you would come forward and receive United Way's Profiling Courage Award.
Didn't prepare a speech at all. I honestly did not know what the award was about until Soma told me. I am beyond honored to be here. When I came here 10 years ago now, I think, there was so much stuff going on in my life that impacted me, and I felt alone so many times. And I stayed committed to my goal of receiving at least my bachelor's, which I did last year. And to see on that screen so many organizations I've either worked with or been a part of is, it's just beautiful. And I feel like I am fulfilling my life's mission of helping others and pouring into others' cup as much as mine has been poured into. So thank you.
As far as I'm concerned, you can keep clapping if you want, because that's well-deserved. Thank you, Shantaria. How inspirational, and thank you, School on Wheels, for the great work that you're doing and continue to do. I have fond memories of my earliest days when I was at the Mainspring Coalition for the Homeless and having Cheryl Opper regale me for hours about the importance of providing services, educational services to the homeless. Thankfully, we heard her, and Steve Talismanic, who's leading the organization now, continues to do tremendous work. So thank you all for that. At this time, we're going to try something we haven't tried before. Technology is clearly not always our friend, but we're going to try to raise some resources for what you know is an important need. All of a sudden, baby formula has become scarce and expensive and hard to find. We're going to hope that we're going to give you a way to contribute some resources in order for us to be able to get some baby formula for the families that are coming to our family center. And I'm going to ask at this time board member Marie Kelly from Stonehill College also to come up and try to explain how to do this, because I couldn't tell you how to do this.
See, Dennis turns it over to me when the technology comes into play, so I can take the heat if
That's
you're
right.
if your phones fail you.
That's exactly right.
But I'm happy to be here today, and thank you so much, and congratulations to all the award winners today. And it's just such a wonderful place to be and see so many wonderful people working in our community to do good. And this is no exception. So today, Dennis has asked that I have you take out your phones or take a look at the back of your programs. There is a QR code on the back. As you all know, with the challenges that we're currently facing in our nation, our region, the world, baby formula and access to baby formula is no exception. It has been heartwarming to see community members rally around families who are just trying to feed their children. So the Family Center is no exception for those of you who have had the pleasure of meeting Tracy Hillman and any of her team members at the Family Center. They are working in the local community to provide resources and programs that strengthen families, and they are committed to making sure that families who do not have access to transportation, cannot get to the store quick enough when the shelves are restocked to get their formula, can come to the Family Resource Center or the Family Center and access that resource. So please take out your phones. You can either text 26989, so the number you see right here on the screen, or you can scan the QR code. If you text 26989, you can text UWGPC and you will get a response with instructions for how to make a gift. If you open your browser after scanning the QR code, you will also get instructions for how to make a gift. Whatever you can give, if you can give, please support this great initiative to make sure that formula gets into the hands of the families in our community who need it. Whatever you can give. If you have any questions, if you're struggling, Kim, I'm going to turn that over to Kim Scotland. Raise your hand if you're struggling. And whatever you can give, if you can give, this is such a great initiative and such a great opportunity to just quickly raise some funds for the Family Center to make sure they can support our families in the community with baby formula. Thank you. Now we'll turn it back over to Dennis.
Marie knew all of that going into being asked this, that she might have been blamed for something. She did it anyway, which is really, thank you, Marie. And thank you to Stonehill College for letting us have you on our board. We really, and our newest member too, much appreciated. At this point, we are at an important juncture in our meeting where it is what we refer to as the keynote address. And our plans originally were to have the new president and CEO of United Way Worldwide to have a virtually live meeting with us so that we could ask her some questions and have her interact. We had planned this more than 6 months ago, and a couple months ago, we got the news that her flight plans had changed unalterably so that she would literally and is in the air right now heading for a United Way of Worldwide Board of Directors meeting. But what she agreed to do was to be recorded in an interview that you're going to see now. And she is a delight, and we are very excited what she brings to the table as the national head of United Way. And to be clear, when we talk about the local United Ways, we are all independent. We all are responsible for certain branding and certain financial requirements, but we are run by a local board of directors. We are a separate 501c3. We just connect for network purposes to the United Way Worldwide. And you'll get that message, I think, when you hear our keynote speaker, Angela Williams. And once again, I'm going to rely on my friend and colleague, Kim Scotland, to get the technology to work for us. And we'll, as Donna Summer says, we're going to dim all the lights. All right, there's not as many disco people as there used to be. Yeah, that's all right. Ready? Yeah, I'm sorry.
Welcome, Angela Williams. We are just ecstatic to have you. At United Way, you know that we are supposed to be saying our thank yous often and loudly, and I think the welcoming is the same thing. We are honored to have you in the midst of our United Way of Greater Plymouth County's 100th anniversary. We have several hundred people who are going to be enjoying listening to you, and we're thrilled. And I would like to lead them in a round of applause for you. It's like the rotary. You thank the speaker right before you have anything to say. We really appreciate you being here, and we're just so excited to have you. And if you don't mind, we're going to jump right into the questions that we have for you, if that's okay. You have come to the United Way worldwide, a family of some 1,600 local United Ways globally, at a very strife-filled and stressed time. As the first African-American woman to head this 135-year-old organization, would you be willing to share a little bit about yourself, more than just recounting your very impressive resume, to share with us a little bit of the life experiences you have so that our audience gets a sense of who you are and what you're bringing to this United Way network?
Well, Dennis, before I do that, I just want to applaud you as the leader and all of your great partners and your staff, and just to say congratulations on reaching 100 years. That is a significant milestone. And I just think you all should be applauded for being such a great partner in your community, meeting needs of people every day, showing up where it counts the most. And you all are doing great things. And I want to just say continue to do what you're doing. And I'm just so proud of you all. And I hope that you all are enjoying your celebration of 100 years.
Thank you. We are. We are, absolutely. Thank you so much.
Yes. Well, to get to your question and a little bit about me, I would say that service is in my DNA. I grew up in the 1960s, the daughter of a Baptist minister, pastor, in Anderson, South Carolina. And my dad was also the head of the NAACP for the state of South Carolina at that time. And during the height of the civil rights movement, where a lot of pastors were coming together to work across denominations for integration and civil rights and social justice, my dad was one of those leaders. And he and my mom decided to heed the call to join the United States Navy, where my dad was the fifth Black chaplain in the history of the Navy. So my parents moved me and my brother from South Carolina to Southern California to start our own journey of service through the military. So having grown up in a military background and on military bases, it only made sense to me that I should join the Air Force. And so I was in ROTC in college and was an Air Force JAG, served on active duty for over 6 years and continued my service in federal service, serving as a federal prosecutor, et cetera. But all along, it was about service. It was about how can I, whether it's in church or working with nonprofits, give back. And that's how we were raised. And to be able to do so now, sitting in this seat as the CEO of United Way Worldwide, this wonderful local yet global organization, is incredible. And then, Dennis, you said something in your remarks when you talked about stepping into this role at this moment in time. There is strife and turmoil all around all of us. And it's no small matter that we are at this moment seeing a crisis economically. We are still in the throes of a pandemic. We still see the need to be able for organizations to be able to quickly change, be flexible and agile to meet the needs. And so even United Way Worldwide and our network is also at this moment in time poised to leap into transformation in a really, really big way. So that's why I think organizations like yours at 100 years, like United Way as a network at 135 years, are in this place of transition. And this is an uncomfortable yet perfect place for us to be.
Well, let me follow up, because you've actually provided a terrific segue for my next question for you, which is, given that our local United Ways are facing so many challenges these days, including gradually declining contributions from our workplace campaigns, greater competition from other nonprofits having to increase their fundraising capabilities, and a younger generation that just doesn't have the same understanding of or commitment to the United Way as our former generations did. With all of those things going on, what confidence do you have that the United Way model will be flourishing in the future for the next perhaps 100 years, if we're lucky? And what are the reasons for your confidence in that United Way model?
So Dennis, I'm going to start with that latter question first and just point out something that I know that you and your supporters know and partners know firsthand. And what the pandemic, the COVID pandemic made clear is that there is still a need for and a role for United Way. And then the other thing I want to share is that you rightly outlined what's happening with the decline in workplace giving, younger folks not engaging as much in the sector, et cetera. I am on the committee of the Generosity Commission. And in some of the readings that we've done and the discussions that we've had, in 2015, volunteerism really hit an all-time low. We also see, as you've pointed out, the nature of philanthropy changing. And as you rightly pointed out, engagement of younger generations is different and harder. So here are a couple of things that as I think about our network, that we should be focused on, starting with the last thing I just mentioned, the younger generation. The way that they engage has to do with, are they connected in their community? And again, data shows that people volunteer and give when they feel this sense of connectivity in their local communities. So are we coming up with ways to reach out to high school students? Are we creating programs around volunteerism and creating avenues that high school students, college students can be connected to United Way, introduced to the notion of volunteerism and giving and generosity more broadly? So that's one thing. Secondly, using technology. Are we creating ways through social media and other ways that connect younger generations to us, to the work that we do, create brand awareness, and again, give them an opportunity to engage, whether it's through time, talent, or treasure. The other thing that I would say that's really important is that we talk about sometimes like brand awareness, or we talk about how do people know who we are and what we do. And there is an intentional effort that we need to make. And United Way Worldwide and my team is committed to doing this work to help support you, Dennis, and other local United Ways to really enhance the brand and elevate the message that you're conveying in community. And certainly when I think about the vision of United Way and our network, it's about elevating communities. And we do that through making communities resilient. We do that by lifting up the various voices in our communities, bringing them to the table to be able to engage in creating these solutions for the issues that are in local communities. And United Way is in a unique position to do that. And we have the skill set, the know-how to bring people together, to collaborate, and also this model and notion of we can continue to do workplace giving campaign, we can engage in philanthropy in other ways, but thirdly, we also have the ability to deliver services, and to be that thought leader, and fifth, to be that convener. So there is room at the table in communities for your United Way and for others to really have lasting impact in communities for generations to come.
It's interesting, Angela, that we're talking about this, one of the aspects that I've loved about United Way is that we're not transactional, that's just, you know, a temporary and yes, we need to raise dollars. There's no question about it. Yes, we need to recruit volunteers, but it's relational. And so my next question is going to relate to that. And that is this, is that, you know, in order for our United Way locally to both survive and thrive, on the partnerships that we have established and the relationships that we have forged and deepened over the years, how do you envision the partnership between United Way Worldwide and our local United Way of Greater Plymouth County, and how should we work together to forge and deepen this vital relationship?
Dennis, you've pointed out something that I think is the beauty of being a federated nonprofit. And the beauty is this, that you have United Way Worldwide and my colleagues and staff team here in Alexandria, Virginia, and we have the ability across the network to, as your annual report shows on the front cover, bright spots. We are able to identify the bright spots, whether it's in Greater Plymouth County or in other communities, and lift those up to engage in the knowledge sharing and the best practices, and to really create the best in class systems and processes and supports that you all need to effectuate change and transformation and impact in your local communities. And that's the beauty. We are a community, multiple thousands of communities connected together as a global network operating in 41 countries. And Dennis, I guarantee you that there is something that you all are doing right now in community that is a bright spot, that if we share it with another community that's addressing the same or similar problem, that you have some nuggets that you can share, and they're transportable. And that's what I love about this United Way and our brand and our perspective. And so I think it's important for me, my team, as we're sitting at this global level and looking around and seeing what you all are doing, making sure that there's connectivity, making sure that we have the best in class tools, processes, and ways to serve you all, to lift up the work that you're doing, to have the best impact that you can have in community, and for us to make the right decisions so that we remain sustainable, impactful, and relevant for yet another century of service.
It's wonderful to hear you talk and outline all of the important and vital things that United Way Worldwide does to support the local system of United Ways that are out here. I mean, in Massachusetts, we have a vibrant system of the Council of Massachusetts United Ways that work together to do exactly what you're saying, sharing best practices, working together collaboratively when we can around some issues that we all share, you know, fighting homelessness, trying to end hunger, all of those kind of good things that we do. So it is exciting, and we're certainly invested from our local perspective in order to continue to connect with you to provide whatever help you need to do the job that you have to do, because we really are thrilled about being part of this network that is so far reaching in its abilities to make differences in people's lives. So it's terrific. Yeah. I have an interesting question or set of questions to end on, and I'm not sure you've ever been asked this before, but we appreciate your willingness to adjust your schedule to be with us today as we celebrate 100 years of caring for our community. We're thrilled about that. You should know that in this room of several hundred folks, we have companies that have supported us, individuals who are leadership givers, community funded partners that are doing the best of the best work. And so we're thrilled that you're here to join with us. But I want to end on this, is I'm sure that somewhere along the line, you have been wondering and hoping to be asked a certain question that you'd be dying to answer that no one ever asks you. They don't think to ask you, even though you have this terrific answer, because it's important to you. So my question is, what is that question that never gets asked? And would you like to have the opportunity to answer that?
Well, thank you for that. So I will just say the question that we should be asking ourselves is this: how can we be architects of the future of our community? And what I mean by that question is are we looking at how can we shape our community, not just a year from now, 3 years from now, 5 years now from now, but 30 years from now? We have to be the architects of our future. We have to recognize that the decisions that you all are making for your community today will impact the community for decades to come. So why not be intentional to think 30 years out from now. One of the things that I have been, Dennis, and I'm sure you've heard me speak about this before, but I always like to focus on this notion of being future forward thinkers. Are we being future forward thinkers? Are we thinking about the future in a way that we're asking the key question? Are we being fast enough? Are we being agile enough? Are we being flexible enough? Are we asking the right questions? Do we have the right people at the table with us? Are we listening to the right voices? Are we going into the communities, not as the savior, but as the listener? First of all, listening and understanding. And then second of all, saying to those in communities that are impacted, why don't you sit with us and co-create the solution for your community? And then thirdly, are we being in this place of partnership and collaboration such that we're building community resilience? So when I think about what we need to be doing now, understanding, as you started our conversation off, Dennis, about what's going on in the world around us, recognizing that we are in this fast-paced era of change and transformation, that every day, every week, we're waking up to new news, new ways of doing things, new technologies, and we in this sector have to be prepared to be able to not just be reactionary, not to be left behind, but to actually be the thought leaders for the future and to be the ones to be able to communicate and articulate, measure, and show up in a way that people who are in need of our services and supports know that they can count on us, United Way, to be there for them.
You know, it's so wonderful listening to you, and I get so inspired by listening to all of the things that you're laying out for us. And it reminds me of all of the things that I sometimes need things to be put very simply. And one of my favorite United Way logos or taglines is, thanks to you, it's working, right? I always love that because it basically embraces all of those supporters who are around us. But I think as we move forward, the current tagline that I've heard coming out from United Way Worldwide is "Together we can." And I think that you've embodied that spirit in what you've just said, and that we can do this, we can work together, we can make a difference. In our case, our mission is to improve lives and to strengthen our community. We can't do that without our friends at United Way Worldwide. We can't do that without our businesses and leadership givers and our community partners and everybody who's in this room as listening to you talk about the future of United Way, and it is bright, and it is challenging, but it is something we can do something great about. So, Angela, thank you so much for taking the time. We know how busy you are, and again, I will repeat our support from a local level of what you need to do as you move forward, and thank you for the inspiration that you're providing so many of our local United Ways in our communities. We really, really appreciate it.
Well, Dennis, I applaud you. I applaud your staff, your volunteers, your board members, your partners, everyone in your community. And congratulations again on 100 years of service.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. We just have a couple things to do before we wrap up, and we appreciate your patience as we go on just a little bit over today, but we kind of figure we maybe have 100 minutes today. I know. Not funny, right? You're done. I do want to report back and give you some important feedback. You folks are so generous. You raised just over $2,000 for baby formula, so thank you for doing that. That is so important. At this time, I'm going to ask Pastor Gilbert if he would come up. You saw one of the testimonies in our testimonial video came from Tonia Kane, who is an incredibly inspirational speaker who has overcome a bunch of obstacles, and she is a motivational speaker trainer. She is coming to do an important couple of events, and I'm going to have Pastor Gilbert do you a little commercial if you can, Pastor, if that's okay. Reluctantly, he says, "Oh, all right." It should be on ours.
Okay. Good afternoon. Dennis is up to his old tricks again. Pleasure to be with you. And let's just give a round of applause for all the award recipients and volunteers. Really, really make a difference. I think we're an awesome team here, but just doing what I was asked to do, we had the privilege, myself and my lovely wife, we had the privilege of being at the Alliance for Drug Endangered Children's Conference in Nashville, Tennessee. And I tell you, this event was the most powerful event I've ever been to, including whether it be church or social, what have you. But it was a bunch of people ranging from all ages that experienced things that we service on today. And this young lady, this Tonya Kane from Baltimore, Maryland, please look her up, TonyaKaneInternational.com. She's a 30-year trauma survivor, and she made it all the way from the bottom, and now she's at the top of in the height of her glory and how God has blessed her. And just people like yourselves have really helped to turn her life around. And I had the opportunity, we met her in the hallway. She came off stage, and you know, usually celebrities go out the side door, so we were bold enough to go to the side door. And I said, hey, won't you come to Massachusetts? She said, yes. I'm like, really? So she's coming to Massachusetts. We're thankful for the team at Massasoit Community College that will be hosting that event. So there's more information on our website. So check it out. There is a QRC code to register. There is an excellent program that she's going to be hosting that Saturday morning for service providers and trainers. But it's just a host of good things. So check that on the flyer. I hope to see you there. And please spread the word.
No, you're good. And just so you know, that's August 6th, which is a Saturday. It's literally the day before our official birthday. And if you don't have the motivation that the pastor just gave you, which I think is plenty, if you need a little bit more, we're planning to have either cupcakes or cake for our birthday at United Way. So you got to come and see it. But she wants to do a training for professionals in the morning, and in the evening she wants to speak to families and share with them her inspiration. Her message, in a nutshell, is there are community resources available, help available, and with that network of services that we so hard to build here, you can get the help you need to overcome whatever your issues and the problems are. So keep a lookout for that. We're excited. At this time, we're leading to the finale here. I am going to bring the chairman of our board, John Doyle, back up to say goodbye and thank you.
So I'm between you and the door. I get to say a lot more thank yous just to close this out. You know, on behalf of our great organization, our board, Dennis and the team, we want to extend our deepest thanks and gratitude for everybody showing up today, and more importantly, for all the work that's done throughout the year. That's really where the rubber meets the road, and there's so much work done behind the scenes, you can't even begin to tell that story in a short meeting like this. I do want to extend some thank yous. We've had the mayor here. I think he's probably gone, but appreciate Mayor Sullivan stopping by. President Clark, thank you again for your commitment to United Way and hosting us. and then all the great sponsors that have sponsored this event today. And the entire room, everybody that's here today supports this organization. And, you know, we're kicking off our next 100 years. And that's pretty exciting. Again, we're just this little blip on the timeline. But we get to be at this cool event celebrating 100 years. So thank you, thank you, thank you. And that'll conclude today's programming. Thanks, everyone.